Hare Krishna. I am extremely grateful to Her Holiness Lavang Ratna Mataji that she has given me an opportunity to share my understanding from Bhagavad Gita for all elder Vaishnavas. So I humbly seek your blessings to speak something, whatever I had from my spiritual masters and other Vaishnavas. So today we are going to discuss about the purpose of Bhagavad Gita. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, as it is. This is from introduction. So we'll read paragraph by paragraph, then we'll discuss something. This is page number 5. Last paragraph. Just what is the Bhagavad Gita? The purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to deliver mankind from the nescience of material existence. Every man is in difficulty in so many ways. As Arjuna also was in difficulty in having to fight the battle of Kurukshetra. Arjuna surrendered unto Sri Krishna, and consequently this Bhagavad Gita was spoken. Not only Arjuna, but everyone of us is full of anxieties because of this material existence. Our very existence is in the atmosphere of non-existence. Actually, we are not meant to be threatened by non-existence. Our existence is eternal. But somehow or other, we are put into asat. Asat refers to that which does not exist. ओम अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानाजन सलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितमेन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनीति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे श्रील प्रभुपाद एक्सप्लेन्स एंड ऑल्सो ही रिक्वेस्ट एवरी डिवोटी दैट वी शुड स्टडी Bhagavad Gita very scrutinizingly. So this is a great service he has given for all of us to understand Bhagavad Gita. So because everything has a purpose, we have a purpose to live in this material world, this whatever building or wherever, all this creation has a purpose. So surely the Bhagavad Gita is having a purpose. And Prabhupada explains, the purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to deliver mankind from the nescience of material existence. So this is Prabhupada explaining, is that to deliver mankind from the nescience of material existence. Like in Nectar of Devotion, Rupa Goswami explains who is qualified or who is eligible for pure devotional service. Then answer it tells that any human being is eligible. The same way Srila Prabhupada explains that to deliver mankind, so among all species, the human form of life is very, very important, is very, very valuable. Because Prahlad Maharaj says that Kamar acharate pragyam dharman bhagavatar niha durlabham manusam janma tadapi adhurvam arthadam. Although this human form of life is temporary, it is very meaningful. Because in this human form of life we can understand. And we can understand what is the purpose, why we are living, what to do, what not to do, why at all I am existing here. So that's what Prabhupada is explaining. That this is to deliver mankind from the nescience of material existence. What is the nescience of material existence? Like nescience means avidya. It's a darkness. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says that Krishna Surya Sama Maya Hai Andhakar Jaha Krishna Taha Nahi Maya Radhikar. Krishna is just like a sun and Maya is darkness. Wherever Krishna is there is no question of Maya. So Prabhupada knows that we are in Maya, means especially the conditioned souls. The conditioned souls are in Maya and they have to be delivered from the clutches of Maya and they have to send back to Krishna. So that is what the material existence is. So in order to deliver from the material existence, this Bhagavad Gita is spoken by Krishna. So Krishna and his Bhagavad Gita are non-different. It is just like Bappu and Bani. Bappu means the physical association and Bani means the instruction coming from the person. So they are non-different. Rather than the instruction is more valuable and more powerful than the person, personal association. Because sometimes we take it granted of the personal association. For example, suppose there is a king sitting and there is a mosquito. Maybe a very close approximate. Close proximity will be there. But what the mosquito is doing? He is sucking the blood from the king. But whereas the other servants, queens or the subject ministers, they are serving. So it is very important that if we live by the instruction of the person, then actually it is a respect. So like Srila Prabhupada has few times he met his spiritual master, Bhakti, his Divine Grace Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. But he led by the instruction given by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Only two instructions he has given. One thing is that you preach in English and whenever you get money, print books. And he has, Srila Prabhupada has taken it into heart and soul and whole life he preparing himself how to fulfill the instruction of my spiritual master. The same way, so this Bhagavad Gita is actually a great compassion for all the conditioned souls. Srila Prabhupada has put all his effort to give this book so that we can live by the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. So always we are interested to see God, But Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur says that we should act in such a way so that God will come and see us. So how will we act? If we act according to the instruction of Krishna or Bhagavad Gita, by his instruction, then definitely all the godly qualities will manifest and Krishna will be happy, will feel satisfaction, will feel happy. So that's what Prabhupada is explaining. The purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to deliver mankind from the nuisance of material existence. There is no doubt all the conditioned souls are suffering from the material existence. Thus every day we pray, Sansara dhava nalanida loka tranaya karunya ghana ghanatma. So the material existence is burning like a fire. And we are, all of us are experiencing this. Every man is in difficulty in so many ways. As Arjuna was also difficulty in having the fight, the battle of Kurukshetra. Every man is in difficulty in so many ways. Because this is the characteristic of this material world. Padam padam yat vipadam natisam. The characteristic of the material world is asasattam dukhalayam. It's a temporary and filled with miseries. We may experience some happiness, but that is not the real happiness. It is just like sand mixing with sweet kheer. We may take sweet kheer, but because sand is mixed, so that we are not able to properly taste it. So same way, this creation is designed in such a way so that we will experience the difficulties. Because this is not our original constitutional position to live in this material world happily. That's what Krishna tells in Arjuna. Krishna tells everything in Bhagavad Gita. And Prabhupada explains, as Arjuna was also in difficulty in having the fight to battle of Kurukshetra. Arjuna was having the difficulty to fight. What was the difficulty for Arjuna to fight in the battlefield? Pardon?
His kinsmen were
opposite. Yeah. So he is giving... Actually, war is declared. War is about to start. And Arjuna is also asking Arjuna, please take me, take my chariot. Arjuna is asking Krishna, please take me, take my chariot. I want to see who are the opponents with whom I am going to fight. And Krishna is taking just, he is putting the chariot in front of Bhishma and Drona. Immediately Arjuna becomes bewildered. That is unable to fight. What is the reason? He has given five reasons. His Grace Bhurijan Prabhu has mentioned five reasons in his book, Surrender. First thing is that immediately he saw his spiritual master, grandfather Bhishma, all relatives, so he started compassion. So that was the reason. How I can fight with my father, grandfather, who my spiritual master, those who have given their life to me, by their mercy I am existing. How I can fight? All of my relatives. Then second reason is giving that suppose I fight and I win, but in their absence I cannot enjoy. Because everything will be tainted with blood. Then he's telling, if I fight, I'm killing all these people, then I will incur sin. And fourth reason is giving that there will be destruction of dynasty, family tradition. And there will be Varnasankara. And for this, I will be responsible. And the last reason is giving that I do not know whether it is good to fight or not to fight. I am not able to decide whether it is better or not better. Actually, Arjuna is a pure devotee of Krishna. And he was put into that difficulty so that we will learn something from that incident. Then question comes, why actually we should learn? Actually, our life is we can mark a, suppose there is a circle or you take a straight line. This present life is just like a dot in a straight line. Because we have come across with so many lifetimes, and there will be so many, just like Krishna says, that we are eternal, and the soul is eternal. Means if this present life is there, past there was life, and future there will be life. So this conditioned soul, he takes his journey from one life to another, like this is going. And in this lifetime, we are facing lot of problems, lot of difficulties. There are so many ups and downs. And there are so many decisions has to be taken. We are tempted with so many problems. So how to live a life so that my journey will be smooth? So that's why these instructions are being given in this Bhagavad Gita. It's just like a lighthouse. Suppose the ship has to move in a sea, then some direction is required. Like lighthouse gives the light. So same way this Bhagavad Gita is nothing but a lighthouse for a conditioned soul to move in his life in such a way so that he can achieve his perfection in this lifetime. So that's what you're telling. So Arjuna was in difficulty in having to fight the battle of Kurukshetra. So if Arjuna has these problems, are we free from those problems? Rather than we have lot of material compassion, lot of attachment. In Bhagavatam it is mentioned, deha apatya kalatradisu atma sanyasu asatsu api tesam pramata nidhanam pasyan api na pasyati. We are attached to body, we are attached to relatives, we are attached to wife, husband, and we are thinking that they will protect us. They are the fallible soldiers. We are thinking they will protect us. Although we know that they cannot protect, still we are attached to that. Pasyanapi na pasyati. And we are always in enjoying mood actually. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim, kavitava jagadish kamaye. But what is our mood? That I want dhana, I want jana, I want everything, I want to enjoy. So this is our mood. So definitely, when we attached to all these things, so suffering is a package actually. Just like we go to market, nowadays there are so many things. You go to purchase something, they are advertising. What? Buy one, get one, free. So this thing also, this is a package. When you are touching something in this material world to enjoy, immediately suffering package is coming. It's a free will come. We need not to pay anything. It's a free. So, because this is the characteristic, Bhagavad Gita explains that ehi sansparsaja bhoga dukkha yono evate adi antavanta kaunteya natesu ramate buddha. Ehi sansparsaja bhoga. The moment we touch to enjoy, immediately suffering attacks us and we cannot escape. But that's why this is actually Bhagavad Gita given by Krishna himself, and he tells that dharma rakshati rakshataha. If you follow the principle of religion, then religion will protect you. The moment we don't follow Bhagavad Gita, we do our actions whimsically, then automatically we are in problem. So that's why this is the guideline. he has given to us. Arjuna surrendered unto Sri Krishna, and consequently this Bhagavad Gita was spoken. Not only Arjuna, but everyone of us is full of anxieties because of this material existence. Our very existence is in the atmosphere of non-existence. Actually, we are not meant to be threatened by non-existence. It's a very important point. We are not meant to be threatened by non-existence, but we are threatened. Because by soul, originally, or means is constitutionally, is the eternal servant of Krishna. As long as he is connected with Krishna, he will be happy, he will be blissful, because Krishna is Sat Chit Ananda. We are part and parcel of him. Mame Vansa Jiva Loke Jiva Bhuta Sanatana. Krishna tells that all these living entities are my part and parcels. We are his parts, because originally we are with him. We are in the spiritual world. We are parts. We develop some desire to enjoy. That's why he parceled to the material world. Okay, you go. I create a material world. You enjoy there. You think that you will be Lord. So that's why we are threatened by non-existence. We are eternal by nature, but by temporary things, we are getting distracted. Always we are threatened. Like, suppose we are sleeping and see the dream, a tiger in the dream. There's no tiger. But sometimes we sweat, sometimes we cry out, sometimes we help. So threatened by non-existence. Forget about sleeping, daytime also. We are attracted by so many things. Prahlad Maharaj says, his prayers are so beautiful. Prahlad Maharaj says, my dear Lord, I am like a person who has many wives. And all these wives, they attract me in different ways. For example, the tongue wants so many palatable things. Belly already filled with so many things. Again, he wants more. Eyes is attracted different sense gratifications. Ear, Prabhupada very nicely explained that ear is attracted to cinema songs. Prabhupada is actually brilliant. So every sentence is actually, every word is a pulse actually. And actually this is not Bhagavad Gita what he has written, it's a love letter actually. Just like Krishna is giving a love letter to Arjuna, same as Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita is a love letter to us. He loves us so much, his compassion. He has given everything to us. Now it is our duty that how we can make proper justice to his selfless sacrifice. So there is a very beautiful story. His Holiness Bhaktidhir Damodar Maharaj recently published one book, Spiritual Connection. In that he has written one very nice story that once there was a spiritual master and he has taken all his disciples to a pilgrimage tour. And they are there in the pilgrimage and one disciple asks to his spiritual master, my dear Guru Maharaj, I have a question. Maharaj told, okay, you ask. He told that among your disciples, there are so many disciples, among your disciples, whom do you like most? And Guru Maharaj told that, I love everybody because I have accepted my disciples, so I love everybody. Then disciple told, yes, I accept that you see everybody equally. Just like a father sees his children equally. But there must be someone who is more dear like this. Then his spiritual master told a story that he has three dolls. One is made up of sugar, another is made of cloth, another is made of stone. And once he was going to river, and all these three dolls fell down in the water. And that is, which is made of sugar, that completely dissolved. And the cloth one get little soaked, then after that it come back to its original position. And the stone is not affected at all. So the theme of the story, he explains, there are three types of disciples. One is Kanishta, one is Madhyama, another is Uttama. The Kanishta Madhyama is always threatened by material existence. That is Kanishta. Means little bit sense gratification is there, he is always attracted. He forgets everything. He forgets his spiritual master's mercy, he forgets blessings, he forgets whatever is done to him. But the Madhyam disciples, he understands things, but sometimes because of his non-fixity, or in the sense, is not so fixed, that's why sometimes he sidetracks, but comes back to its original position. But those are Uttama disciples, the best disciples, they are not affected by any material existence. So same way, Srila Prabhupada expects us that we should become the Uttama Bhakta. That's why he has written in this book that even by reading this Bhagavad Gita, even if one person become a pure devotee of Krishna, I consider that my writing is successful. So now, because of his mercy, because of his compassion, because of his blessings, so many pure devotees are around us, and we are taking their blessings, their advantage, so we feel very grateful actually. So like day before yesterday, Mataji was telling that how fortunate we are. They're telling 4 billions of this universe, world, we are in 84 crores of Vrindavan, this Braja course means Braja, and in this, that there's the Krishna Balaram temple, and inside the Krishna Balaram temple, this is Srila Prabhupada's house, and we, in the evening, we are hearing Bhagavad Gita. And you go to the material world, what they are doing? Most of them, they are running here and there, parks. Somebody will be in the wine shop, somebody will be somewhere else, sea beach. Just compare our life. How peaceful we are. Krishna says, my devotees, Srunanti Gayanti, in Bhagavatam, Srunanti Gayanti, Grunanti Abhikshana, Smaranti Nandanti Tabehi Tajana, Taeva Pasyanti Achirena Tabakam, Bhava Pravaha Paramam Padam. Those who hear, those who study, those who sing the glories, even somebody appreciates this Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, they are also free from all type of miseries. Bhava Pravaha Paramam Padam. So we are very, very fortunate to be in this place and discussing Krishna Katha. Actually, I am expressing my gratitude to my spiritual master and all those devotees, they have helped me. Because I was also, in the same way, living a life of sin. Because of their mercy, actually this, yesterday, Mataji was asking, please share your realizations, that how you came in contact with Bhagavad Gita, what is your realization? So this Bhagavad Gita, actually, I was filled with so much anxieties. And I was in the office, and my spirit, Patha Pradasa Guru, my guide, he was always reading Bhagavad Gita. I said, what, this person is not doing work and all, reading always Bhagavad Gita? So I asked him that, what you are reading? Told I read Bhagavad Gita. Then I had some inclination, so I asked him, so can you give me one Bhagavad Gita? So he gave me this big original Bhagavad Gita to me. And immediately I took it. And within 1 month I finished from beginning to end. But of course I didn't understand fully. But he chapter by chapter and all these things he explained me. And I feel very grateful. Because of him, my life is saved. So this is what actually, now we can understand that what is sat and what is asat. What is temporary, what is permanent. Then second paragraph, I request if somebody can read. Out of so many human beings.
Unless he realizes that he doesn't want suffering, but rather wants to make a solution to all suffering, then one is not to be considered a perfect human being. Humanity begins when this sort of inquiry is awakened in one's mind. In the Brahma Sutra, this inquiry is called Brahma Jigyasa. Atato Brahma Jigyasa. Every activity of the human being is to be considered a failure unless he inquires about the nature of the Absolute. Therefore, those who begin to question why they are suffering or where they came from and where they shall go after death are proper students for understanding Bhagavad Gita. A sincere student should also have a firm respect for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Such a student is Arjuna.
Okay. So in this paragraph, Srila Prabhupada explains that one should inquire. If you don't inquire, then you will not get answers. So that's why this is the distinction between human form of life and animal life. Animal cannot inquire. Although we can see sometimes those are killers of goats. They will take all the goats in one place and put some grass and all the goats will be started chewing this grass, one by one he will be cutting. All the goats will be watching, but they don't have anything to protest. But here, that facility is there in human form of life. Suppose there is a pain in the knee. It is good or bad? Suppose there is a pain in the knee, and I'm experiencing. So it is good or bad?
Bad.
Okay. Why it is bad?
You don't feel happy.
Okay, say that.
I think it's good.
Yes.
Because then you can understand that being in the body is not good.
Very good. Yeah, thank you very much, bro. It is good because if it does not give me pain, so what will happen, after some time, if there is a problem inside the knee, so then inside there will be problem, it may develop to cancer also. Without my knowledge, I will die. That is the thing. So the pain is good, so it indicates there is some problem in your body. So immediately we should consult with the doctor and get rectified. So that's why this material world is designed to experience this suffering, so that we will inquire. Am I here to suffer in this material world? That's why I'm living for this? Is God cruel? That God is putting us into difficulties? Why there are varieties? So somebody is rich, somebody is poor, somebody is in man's body, somebody is woman's body, somebody is blind from the birth, somebody is... There are so many varieties. Why this is? Why there is so inequalities? This inquiry, only human form of life can do that. That's why Srila Prabhupada tells that out of so many human beings who are suffering, there are few who are actually inquiring about their position. We are not animals. okay, chalega, whatever sufferings come, we should tolerate. That is not, this is not the, that's why this human form of life is not given. Then we are equal to animal. Ahara nidra bhaya maithuna cha samanyam etat pasuvir naranam dharma hi eka adhika viseso dharmena hina pasuvir samana. That they are eating, we are eating. They are sleeping, we are sleeping. They are depending, mating, we are also doing that. So what is the difference? Difference is dharma. Arthato brahma jignyasa. Who am I? Why am I suffering? Like Sanatana Goswami. He is a very learned scholar. He knows so many languages. He was a prime minister. He was wealthiest person. But the moment he met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his first question was, that people are telling that you are so learned, so scholar, but I do not know who am I. I am a fool number one. Why I am suffering? So this is the question that we should ask ourselves. That is the purpose of Bhagavad Gita. That you are not the body, you are the soul. The whole second chapter, Srila Krishna tells Arjuna. Arjuna thinking that he is great, greatest warrior, he can conquer everything and all these things. But Krishna chastises Arjuna that you are fool number one. You are speaking like learned persons, but you do not know who you are. So that's why it is our duty to understand that who am I, why I am suffering, what is the solution, how I can get solution. So this purpose of Bhagavad Gita will give the solution. Yesterday also someone Mataji was sharing that she had so many problems in her life. Somehow she met one devotee, she asked that I am filled with so many problems. Can you give me some solution? Because all the solutions are available in Bhagavad Gita. It was that I want that Bhagavad Gita. Then that guy told that you have to chant 16 rounds, maintain 4 regulative principles for 6 months. Then you will get this Bhagavad Gita. And then Mataji was actually serious. And she chanted 16 rounds and maintained 4 regulative principles till 6 months. Then that guide gave, okay, you take the Bhagavad Gita and read it. And immediately she started reading from beginning to end. Again, because she is, I think, Chinese or something. So she told that I could not understand anything at all. So no problem, you be in prayerful mood, because you cannot understand by your own knowledge or logic, whatever. You require mercy. So you have to be pray. You have to pray to Krishna. You have to be humble. You have to surrender. Then this knowledge will be revealed to you. So then she was feeling, expressing her gratitude that yes, because of the mercy of these devotees and Srila Prabhupada, today I am a stable devotee. So all the solutions to all our problems is available in Bhagavad Gita. There is no doubt in it. I also personally experienced the same thing. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also says, pratyaksha avagamam dharmam susukham kartam evam. Everything can be personally experienced. So nothing is impossible. Means all the solutions are available in this Bhagavad Gita. And also explained that one very beautiful line. Yeah, humanity begins when this sort of inquiry is awakened in one's mind. Every activity of the human being is to be considered a failure unless he inquires about the nature of the absolute. That means if we don't know who we are, who is God, what is our relationship, what is absolute truth, then our human form of life is wasted. It's a failure. Like Srimad Bhagavatam says, dharma swanushtita punsam visvaksena kathasu yaha na utpadayate yadiratim srama evahi kevalam. It is srama only. the occupational duties which we are doing, performing according to Varnanda Ashrama, if it does not provoke an attraction to hear Krishna Katha, it is a useless labor. It is a waste of time. That's what Prabhupada explains. Prabhupada does not speak even a single sentence from his own. Everything he refers from Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, somewhere. That's why there is no difference between the pure devotees of Krishna and Krishna, because they walk and they talk according to the instruction of Krishna. Okay, third paragraph. Anybody else? It's going to Lord Krishna descends. Any Matajis?
Which chapter? I don't know.
Third, Lord Krishna descends.
Even then, out of many, many human beings who awaken, there may be one who actually enters the spirit of understanding this position, and for him, this Bhagavad Gita is spoken. Actually, we are all swallowed by the tigress of nascence, but the Lord is very merciful upon living entities, especially human beings. To this end, he spoke the Bhagavad Gita, making his friend Arjuna his student. Being an associate of Lord Krishna, Arjuna was above all ignorance, but Arjuna was put into ignorance on the battlefield of Kurukshetra just to question Lord Krishna about the problems of life so that the Lord could explain them for the benefit of future generations of human beings and chalk out the plan of life. Then men could act accordingly and perfect the mission of human life.
Okay, that's all, till that. So, Lord Krishna descends specifically to re-establish the real purpose of life when man forgets that purpose. So Krishna, that is his compassion, because he loves us so much that he does not want us that we should suffer in this material world. That's why he personally comes, he sends his pure devotees, he sends his shastra, scriptures, and he personally manifests in the form of Archa Vigraha, and specially in this Kali Yuga he has manifested in the name of holy name. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So he has come to re-establish, in the fourth chapter, यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिः भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम् अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सुज्जाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधूनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे. He comes personally to re-establish the principle of religion. So by these teachings we are going to get out from all type of avidya, nisayans. There are so many ways, sufferings, and the root cause of all suffering is avidya. So he is addressing the root. Then being an associate of Lord Krishna, then this paragraph, last paragraph, Prabhupada explains that Arjuna was put into bewilderment so that we will learn Bhagavad Gita. Like Gita Mahatma, it is explained that sarvapanishado gavo dugdha gopala nandana partho vasya sudirbhokta dugdham gitamrutam mahat. The Gita Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita, the essence of all the Upanishads is just like a cow, and Lord Krishna, who is famous as a cowherd boy, is milking the cow, and Arjuna is just Arjuna is just like a calf, and Narayana scholars and pure devotees are to drink the nectarian milk of Bhagavad Gita. So all the Upanishads, the essence of all Upanishads is compared to Bhagavad Gita, this Gita Upanishad. And who is the milkman?
Krishna.
And the cow gives milk. First of all, the calf has to come and drink it. Otherwise, cow will not give milk. But what happens? Calf just touches, then it goes back, then the rest of the milk is drunk by all of us. So same thing, all the learned scholars and pure devotees of Krishna, they drink this nectarian milk. So this Bhagavad Gita is not only meant for the conditioned souls, but also meant for liberated souls. Because the more, just like a sandalwood. The sandalwood, the more you rub, the more fragrance you'll get. So the liberated souls, they get more, just like if, when we love somebody and he sends some love letter, we read it again and again and again and again. We never tired. So same way, Srila Prabhupada, this Bhagavad Gita is really amazing. So we are all grateful to him for his wonderful contribution. So we express our gratitude to him. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. If any discussions, yes. Mike. Mataji, Mike. That Mataji is sharing her experience. She told that because she was very inquisitive, that I have so many problems, I want some solutions. Then that person was really testing that Mataji, whether actually she is sincere or not. So she was telling, you chant 16 rounds for 6 months, then I'll give to you. So that means that guide is preparing that Mataji to receive. That how, just like we are suppose hungry. So sometimes if something is there, they increase our hunger so that we'll test it more. So I think that guide has told that, okay, you chant some round so that some purification will take place, then you'll be able to understand Bhagavata. Maybe that is.
Give some comment. Just like Prabhupada, he went to the West.
Yes.
He did not ask anybody anything.
Correct.
He just chanted and everybody came to him, and then they asked what we should do. Then Prabhupada said, we have to do this, all these things. And if you can do it, it's okay. Then they did like that.
Correct.
And once also in Harinam, we were distributing Japmala, Kanti Mala, we were distributing. One person came to me, and we were other devotees were standing together. He said he's working in some restaurant and he's making veg, non-veg, everything. So I like to have Kanti Mala. I told him, no, you cannot get Kanti Mala unless until you leave the job and you do this one, that one, then this will happen. And I tell him, why are you telling like this? Giving, never mind. When Kanti Mala will be there, automatically things will happen. This time we'll give him favorable and he will come up from there. So I gave him Kanti Mala and Chapmala, you take this one and do this one. Later on, sometime he came to the temple and he said he was in the restaurant, now he's having another restaurant job and there is no non-wage in this one, he's chanting. So things happen according to Krishna's will.
Yes, correct. But
sometimes we are stubborn that you have to do this one. And also one of my friends used to come to the temple and happily told him, Amitabh, you are chanting. I am chanting 2 rounds. Oh, why 2 rounds? We should chant 16 now.
Yes.
So first we should give opportunity to start the person 1 round, 2 rounds.
Correct.
And I told you, never mind whatever I told you, but what I'm telling you, go according to your capacity. Now I'm taking 2 chapati. If somebody you force me to give you 4 chapati, I said, cannot digest.
Yes, sure.
When regularly things will come, things will happen. But sometimes we are so much aggressive, and if anybody we meet, oh, you have to chant 16 now.
Correct.
You cannot chant even one noun and you ask him to chant 16 now, he will be not interested.
Yes,
sure. So allow him to do okay, you start with one round, then you will get the taste, you do two rounds, three rounds. Similarly, when I join my service, I'm not chanting even one, two rounds. But I just did one, two rounds, and then we came to 16 rounds.
Correct.
In the very first times we say, you know, chant 16 rounds, this one. Sometimes we are too much heavy for the person who is coming, new person. So we should see what is his capacity, according to the capacity we should
be there. Exactly. That is what Krishna says in 3rd chapter, 26th verse. Na buddhi bheda janayed ajnanam karma sanginam josayate sarva karmani vidvanyukta samacharam. That we have to understand the person, what is his propensities, how much he can digest. According to him, he is josayate sarva karmani. He can engage him in those activities so that slowly, slowly he can come to Krishna consciousness. Like Prabhupada tells, that his order that you distribute my books, he never tells you first to go and ask whether you are chanting or not chanting. We just, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Yare dekho tare kaha Krishna upadesh. Bharata bhumite haile nonsha janma jar, janma sarthaka kari para karokvar. So we have to do our service, but just see our realization. Yes.
Since she had some... Yes, one minute. Seems she had some special qualities, some special that he was inspired to give him such a high qualification to read, to even get the book. I never heard such a story.
Yeah.
So he must have seen a very special quality.
Maybe.
Because I hear Prabhupada touch Srinu. Even Bhagavad Gita 14th chapter, it says, even if you are not doing anything, you're full of sinful activity and you are not doing anything, but you just come and just touch, you know, just hear. And that will give you the punya, the gratis sukriti.
Yeah.
And you will get the qualification. Just by hearing, just by coming in the assembly like this, just by coming into this class and putting your body here.
Yes.
You will get the qualification.
Got it. Yes.
But so she must be very from her last life, you know, be picking up
correct
from some advanced position.
Yes. Thank you. Okay. We'll stop here. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.